Hi, I'm Susan Fancher. I'm the simulation coordinator at the HITS Lab, the Health Information Technology and Simulation Lab that is currently in Temple Hall, along with the Smart House that is in the basement of Temple Hall.
We have 4 exam rooms, and we also have telehealth technology that we can bring into these rooms. In addition to 2 of the rooms are, we can do put mannequins in this space too, in addition to using what's called standardized patients or actors who will play the patients. Sometimes with simulations, it's more beneficial to use a mannequin if we're doing more procedural-based simulations, or other times if a communication-based scenario is more appropriate for the students, then we will either have a volunteer or hire an actor to play the parts of the patients, and that will occur a lot in these areas.
It's a double patient room, or we can pull apart this sliding screen and make this room 2 different patient rooms, so we potentially have up to 4 patient rooms at one time that we could have simulations going on in them all at the same time.
Is the pediatric suite. There are 5 head walls in this area, so we can either make it a single room pediatric area, or we can put several beds in here, make it a newborn nursery, or make it a neonatal intensive care. This room is very flexible because we do have the 5 head walls in here, and all of the head walls that you see in the patient areas actually work. So if we put in suction canisters or oxygen, that we really do have suction capability. Oxygen doesn't come out of the wall, but we have air that simulates that oxygen is actually blowing to the patient. So all of the things that you see in this area really are functioning.
This room is very flexible. As you can see, we have several screens hanging from these walls that we can pull down to make the setting different. We were able to go into 2 different hospitals in the area, Park West and Children's, and we took pictures in their actual patient room.
This is the smart home portion of the HITS lab, and it will be used for different things in the College of Nursing along with the College of Engineering. Some of the ways that we will use it in the College of Nursing are to do simulations surrounded with community health or public health in the home setting, and in addition to potentially taking a patient from the home, you know, even putting them on a stretcher when an EMS crew is called, or doing things like end-of-life care with hospice, or different kinds of things like that. Anything that you can think of that could potentially happen with a patient in the home. And the College of Engineering, Dr. Lee, is doing a lot of research surrounded with sensor technologies that he's going to be installing a lot of sensors in this space to see how a client moves within their own space of their home and how that affects their daily living and keeping track of movement within a space.
This is one of the debriefing rooms, or we can use this also as a classroom. We have the smart board installed here so that we can pull up the video that we've just recorded also in the control room to allow the students to all be in one space when we're doing the debriefing, so that, again, we can have them look at what just occurred and see those annotations or comments that were recorded by the faculty members as the scenario was unfolding.
The space is the control room. This is where all of the controls would be. If we're using a mannequin in the space, we would control the mannequin from here. Anytime we wanted to make vital signs changes or make the mannequin do anything different, that would be controlled in here. The faculty members would be in this area observing the students as they're in the space, separate from the faculty. So the faculties will not be in the areas where the simulation scenarios are occurring.
I'm feeling very dizzy.